Hi, my name's Grace Greenan, and I'm a singer, songwriter, and artist. There's so many ways that I can classify myself. I've always found it really hard to fit myself into a box and describe myself in one way with one label. And I think I've just come to saying I'm an artist because it kind of encapsulates everything that I do.
Smiles anyways.
I look terrible.
My mom would always just stop at Target and buy a CD for me, even if she didn't know who it was or what it was.
I think it's fair to say I play all of these instruments very mediocrely. I wouldn't say that I'm an instrumentalist as much as I'm a songwriter. And I wouldn't say that I'm a singer as much as I am an artist.
I think that if I were to name the one thing that I was good at, it's songwriting. There's something about conceptualizing a way to represent your feelings. Like I needed somebody and I could put on an album and I would feel like I wasn't alone. Around the age of 12 and 13, my songs started to get really dark. And I think that that's when I knew why music was so important to me. I think being such an energetic person made me a really easy target, just because I was loud. I didn't really have a lot of friends. In the absence of a surplus of friends, I had a lot of time to focus on writing. When you're a kid, you build your identity off of what others say about you, and I built my identity off of people telling me that I was annoying or loud. And they were right. They were totally right. I was loud and also annoying. But it was me. It's weird thinking back to a time when I would silence myself for other people, because now I give myself this platform to openly express who I am as a person. I think if I had to tell myself one thing when I was a little girl, it would be to stop worrying about what people think of you. Because the people who are saying the nasty things about me did not have the same interests as I did. I really do think that the best music is the kind that comes from pain.
Do you want it all if it's all mediocre? Staring at the wall in a wall full of posters. Looking in my dreams, who I wanna be. I guess you gotta see it to believe. Who I've been a fool.
When I think about people like Mac Miller and Rex Orange County.
Spending the years together, growing older.
And Jesse Reyes.
In a car, girl, tie your hair up
and Billie Eilish.
Now red, my bloody no sleep.
And Demi Lovato. They are, you know, the reason that I am inspired in life. They're the reason that I can know that what I'm doing with my time is valuable. Even if nobody listens to my music, even if nobody likes my music, whether or not I release it, it's still being made. I think because of my insecurities, I always needed an extra push to believe in myself. The problem was never songwriting or, you know, being able to do certain things or have the motivation to do them. It was always, am I good enough for this? And that moment came when Steve Blue walked into my life. The idea of recording in such a beautiful space with very, very talented engineers, it wouldn't have been the same. I think I really needed to see that and understand what it was in order to do it. And Steve was the one that showed me that it was possible. He was the one that showed me that I was capable of doing it. And he made me believe in myself more than I ever could. That's where I met Brad.
Just so you know, honest is gonna be unusable.
And I forced him to like me because the only way I was going to be able to genuinely write music and record my feelings in front of these people was if they were my close friends. So I forced Brad to be my friend. And he still is! Which is dope! After a couple of years of being in my a cappella group in college, I decided that I wanted to be a leader. So I ran for VP and I got it. And they all turned into my absolute lifelong best friends. I always think it's funny because my band was built from the fact that the pianist from my a cappella group was a producer, the beatboxer was an amazing guitar player, and so simultaneously, my dream, the more I talked about it, the more that I envisioned what I wanted my life to look like for the next year, the more that it just kind of fell into my lap. Honestly, I don't think that music would be the same if I didn't have a support system. My friends now are beautiful people that I could have never dreamed of having in my life.
Head to the rafters, baby.
Pack to the rafters?
Back to the rafters.
No way.
Gratitude.
Really?
Gratitude.
Wow.
Good.
It's packed?
Packed. Everybody, Josh, Sam, everybody's going.
Hey for you. It's go time.
Love your audience. Feel the love.
So friends, families, strangers would come up to me after Emerald City and they'd be like, when's the next show? And I was like, oh no, like I didn't even think I'd get this far. Like, I didn't even think that people would show up, and they showed up. It's a really funny thing to be in a position where you achieve your life's goal and you didn't prepare for it because you didn't think you'd get that far.
For you, might go to jail for you, I might shoot the dare for you, but I'm guessing.